There's an easy way to improve the performance of almost any Makita power tool. Take this Milwaukee battery and clip it on.
That's impossible.
I've just done it. Look at that. Milwaukee battery, Makita power tool.
They're not interchangeable. We know that. No brand's going to allow somebody else's battery to go into their device, and there's no way a Milwaukee one can fit into a Makita one.
Yeah, but I think they should, actually. You know, they've done that in mobile phones, haven't it? You've got to now have the USB-C. Should manufacturers be making batteries compatible between products? Should be the forced to do that? Put a comment below if you think that would be a sensible way forward, because I certainly do.
Okay.
But I think I've actually solved the problem, Gary.
Okay.
So look, there you go. There's my Milwaukee battery.
Yep, that's clearly a Milwaukee battery, yes.
Yep, and here's our Makita tool. Yep. And there you go, got it working together.
I think there's a little bit more to it. Do you want me to bring the camera in and let's have a closer look?
Okay, well, no, look, here's the Milwaukee battery. Look, they've even improved it even more. Even now has a USB charge port in the top as well.
Even though it's the A and not the C, but we'll let them off that one. Yeah, okay.
There you go.
Yeah, it seems a little fatter than normal though, doesn't it? It seems a little taller.
Okay, that's just a slight confession here. I have been on a well-known online retailer that does next-day free delivery, and I found this battery adapter. I'll try to get it off. No, if I push the right buttons, it might help. There we go. That is the Milwaukee to Makita battery adapter.
Right, okay. So it'll take this 18-volt battery and allow it to be connected to our impact driver just with that little bit of kit in between.
Yeah, so we've just discovered these. This is a new new wizardry that we found. So if you are using one of these, let us know your thoughts about it. Apparently, you can't use it to charge the batteries. It doesn't work in reverse. You have to remove it. So I don't know if you can charge a Milwaukee battery on a Makita charger.
Okay, so that'd be a great comment to leave. And if you want to leave a comment as well about how well Gordon detached it from the product as well, that'd be a nice one to hear as well. But I know when you're on an online retailer that offers next day delivery, it often throws you something else that you might be interested in when you're looking at these adapters.
A wild card, yeah? You were interested in that, so you might be interested in this, Gary. Absolutely right. There is another version that's the same technology clips to a Milwaukee battery, but just has two wires coming out the back.
Okay, shall we just have a little look at that then? So it's N18 volt. Well, I can't believe that's 18 volts. Yeah. It's some sort of adapter then,
yeah? 2mm contact there, and it comes out with some wires.
Well, let me have a little feel of the weight. I can tell you now, in my engineering judgment, see this one here?
Yeah.
It's soldered to this red one, and this one here is soldered to this black one, I think, and that's technology.
Yeah, that's what it could do. But on the data sheet forward, it says it's got short circuit and reverse polarity protection in there.
Okay.
I think these originally, if your planet went to robot wars or something like that, and you need some power for your robot, that's what they're intended for.
But what did you use it for?
So what I've done is managed to convert our favourite soldering iron, the TS100, I'll power it up. So are you ready for this?
So this is the one we just looked at.
Yeah.
So I've already... and you've gone away and done a Blue Peter style connection here. So that's going to power a soldering iron.
Yeah, it's going to power our soldering iron. So I'll just clip that in there. We've got power. And then we've got our TS100 that we used before. You can see it's already getting ready for action. And we love this iron. It heats up super quick. Watch this. And it's going to just start heating up there.
Incredibly quick. Check out that review. I'm sure you'll leave it in the link in the description. The TS100 soldering iron. Yeah. So that's now running off my Milwaukee battery.
Yeah, it is. And that's how we use it. So people, you're doing a lot of LED strip on site, something he likes to call lead tape.
You can get a battery soldering on.
You can get a battery
soldering on. You can get a gas soldering on.
Well, you can. And people said Milwaukee do one. We haven't got one yet. But by being battery's going to be heavy, we like this iron, ideal for lead tape, delicate work, getting in close, you know, when you've got those pads close together.
Okay.
So I think this is a great solution.
So pricing, give me a ballpark figure for this very, very lightweight adapter I've got. How much was this roughly?
I think that was about £10 actually. So
I've actually made a battery soldering iron for a tenner.
Yeah, if you've already got one that works on low voltage, which we do on there. But you'll notice I've added some additional stuff here. I've added a fuse because, as I say, it said this had short circuit protection. If I take it apart.
Do you want to do that? Yeah, so we will show you how we did this Blue Peter style hookup later on in the presentation, but let's first of all have a look what's inside one. I doubt there'll be a lot in here.
Yeah, and this is, I'll just undo this.
Got mini screws?
Your favourite stubby screwdriver here, Gary, from the Slim. There we are.
Yeah, don't mention my height, please. Here we go. Oh, there's going to be bits everywhere. You've got one screw to go.
Just nearly that. So
here we go. So, moment of truth.
Dump those on the desk. Yeah. So, I can't actually see a lot of electronics in here. So, I can see some pads.
Am I right or you right?
No, I think you were right.
Wow.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay, so there's no fuse there, is there?
There's no fuse there. And the wires don't match the ident on the circuit board. You'll see that one says B plus going to the black and B minus going to the red. However, on this side they are right. So the red wire does make its way to the plus side of the battery. If I just double check that, you'll see.
You can see, it's
actually correct, but it's the circuit board that's wrong, so you're a trusted manufacturer there. So I built this.
Well, with the bits that we had lying around, I would suggest you mackle that together. Shall we take a look at Blue Peter A-Team style setup we've got down here?
First up, we need a donor appliance. I've decided to take the lead off our Makita fan because it has the same type of jack plug on the end, positive in the middle. So I'm just going to cut the end off just in case, Gary.
Okay, so you left us a little bit there in case we need to use it as a donor in the future.
Yeah, so I'm just going to find out which wire goes to which pin on the plug. So we're trying to identify the positive and negative because we don't want to connect our iron the wrong way around. So just strip off the ends.
Okay, can you bring your multimeter in for this, is it?
Yeah, bring the fluke in, trusty fluke, on a continuity setting here. So just, it works. So we're just going to, one lead on the outer pin, so the outer is negative. And then, there we go. And then just double check.
It's always a way, isn't it? You know that one's right, so you just check the other one is right as well.
Yeah.
It's got to be, hasn't it? Yeah, there you go. So that's the positive pin.
Yeah. So remember, the one with the printed line on is the positive pin.
Okay, what was that? I can't remember.
Positive.
Yeah. Okay, fine.
Yeah. So we're going to fit a fuse holder to this, so to carry a 20mm fuse, just in case someone should accidentally short out the battery. So I'm just going to attach the fuse holder, cut the red wire.
I like that. Did we need that?
We've got it, so
we're going to use it. Yep, okay. Bit of the eFIXX branding on there. Yeah.
Just strip that. Strip the wires back from the battery adapter. Need to be quite closely coupled here. So we're just going to put on the first part of the fuse holder. Now, here's a top tip. Never, ever forget to put that on.
Right, okay. So I suggest that's from experience.
Yeah, otherwise I'll be doing it again.
Okay, so these are a little bit fiddly, yeah.
A little bit fiddly, like a little cord grip at the end. You just fold them over.
Okay, are you going to bother soldering after this, or are you going to go with that?
No, I'd solder, because just, yeah.
So to make an adapter for a soldering iron, we need a soldering iron?
Yeah, it's always the way of a soldering iron. It's the repair of a soldering iron. You need a soldering iron, so you always need two. So just a little bit of solder on that half, and that's half the fuse holder done. Let's just put the second half on, so again, remember to thread this, and there's another bit to remember. It's the spring.
To keep that contact.
In.
Same bezel again, same idea, little brass bezel.
Smaller wire, so I'm just going to fold it over just to increase the surface area of that wire. So again, put that in place. Long nose pliers in, just put the little cord grip over.
It is fiddly, isn't it?
Yeah, love a bit of electronic assembly. Mm. Even your wires and your screws. There we go. More soldering.
Yeah, okay.
Just assemble the fuse holder, 20mm fuse holder in there. Again, just push them together. There we go, that's pretty secure.
Back out with it again.
Yeah, another bit of eFIXX branded heat shrink.
Our friends at Panelcom gave us that. Unfortunately, they only gave us it in one size, so we're going to make it fit this time around.
So we're just going to do the negative connection here, so we're going to splice these two wires together.
Okay, like a married through joint, I think I did when I was in my apprenticeship. Trying to get them to blend.
What you want is a nice inline soldered connection that doesn't bulge out too far. So
nothing like this one then?
Nothing like this one, no. Okay. It's been a while, Gary.
We didn't see much of that, did we? Okay, so they're on. I'll take it you're desperately at your heat gun on them.
Yeah, heat gun on. We probably could have done with some smaller heat shrink. Possibly adhesive lined would have been better. We'll have to go back down to our friends Penelcom and Hastings to get some going.
Okay, it still looks good though, doesn't it? It's not quite the right stuff, but it still looks good. Yep, I'm going to have a pan over it quickly now. That's it.
So now let's just...
More testing, is it?
Well, just check continuity. Again, we're just going to...
Centre pin.
Just prove.
Okay, so that's positive?
Yeah, that's positive. And then...
Let me guess, you're going to check the other one as well? Yeah. Okay, I'll bet this is a negative. Okay, is that negative?
It is.
Yeah. Okay.
So we're ready to go. So here's bringing our Milwaukee battery. It's fully charged.
So 18-volt battery.
18-volt battery.
Oh, something satisfying about that.
Clicks in nicely. And just we'll disconnect the soldering iron from its mains adapter.
Ooh, yeah.
Just press the power up. And this iron heats up incredibly quickly.
Yeah, if you haven't seen the review of that, I'd recommend you check out that TS100, isn't it?
Yeah, just check the voltage, just because we can.
Oh,
20 volts. I'm going to rebrand that battery as the M20.
Like with everything, once you've gone through the process, I'm sure you can think of a better way of doing it, and you probably have come up with one, haven't you?
Yeah, well, now realising there's not actually much in this box, I could probably, if you just bring the hand camera in here, I'd probably take the wires straight in, so I'd take these off.
Right.
And I think you could probably... smuggle that fuse holder in underneath there.
Ah, right, so it'd look a lot tidier job then, wouldn't
it? Yeah, and then you've just got wires coming out, and then you'd only have to take the cover off if you did short circuit the battery. Conflicting things when it comes to the Milwaukee battery. On the data sheet for the battery, it says it's got overcurrent protection in it. It'll shut down if you're drawing too much current.
Right, okay.
But on the same data sheet, it also says don't short circuit the terminals. So if there's any Milwaukee battery experts out there who've dismantled one of these, I don't really want to because these aren't cheap. Just fire a comment below if there is actually protection in there and we could possibly emit that fuse.
Okay, that keeps the community up to date. Obviously, we've now got, you know, we saw our sacrificial power unit here, but you think you've come up with a cunning plan for it, haven't you?
Yeah, so that was the power adapter that went with this Makita fan. So this 40-volt fan.
Okay, which runs on the 40-volt batteries.
Which runs on the 40-volt battery.
And only the 40-volt family, is it? Or does it do all of them?
It only runs on the 40-volt battery.
So you've got to buy those, yeah.
Or it runs on this adapter that's actually 15 volts.
Right.
So I think...
You're not going to be able to run it off our...
I suspect.
We're going to run it off a Milwaukee battery.
Plug that in there, take that off the soldering iron.
If this works.
Plug it in the back of there.
So this was the mains adapter.
That's the mains adapter. I've now replaced the mains adapter with a Milwaukee battery, our adapter, and our Blue Peter style connection. Are you ready for the power up?
So we're now running a Makita fan on a Milwaukee battery.
Yeah, lovely. So I bet they'll love that. That's the another Christmas card gone from Makita and probably from Milwaukee.
As always, we're interested in your comments, and there was loads of opportunity in this video to add your feedback and add your experiences in there. Have you been using these adapters that allow you to cross-pollinate the batteries from the lovely Milwaukee range into the ones from Makita? Please leave those comments below, and we'll have great fun getting back to as many as we can.